span of over 149 fights, world champions on the one championship roster. And they open up like house on fire. Knee there from Cutler. A lot, a bundle of power. A human firecracker. Eats a right hand from Cutler. Trying to put hands on the Filipino. Here's the only take of power. Now let's see if that influences Ballard to want to take Catalan down. I think it does.
Yeah, you said it. You said if he tastes the power of Catalan, is he going to rethink his game plan? And it looks like he's doing that. Now he's got that body lock takedown. One thing we've seen from the entire Catalan clan is an improved wrestling defense and offense. Catalan, so far he's managed to maintain this upright position with that underhook he's got on the left side. Let's see how long he can maintain it.
Catalan, nice knee. And again for the Muay Thai world champion. Alan throws some knees of his own. Cuban trying to manhandle the Filipino. Overhook on the left arm there from Catalan.
Braces can I aim? Catalan's can I aim? I think I can hear about six.
Tonight in our main event. 20 years old, we're going to become this two-weight world champion. As Robin Catalan fires a round kick off the back leg. Along with a big overhand left down a southpaw's dance. Side of the thighs, the crowd of Gustavo Ballard. Getting airborne. This one, he's starting to get crazy. And it has already in the opening round. Highly entertaining.
Catalan starting to touch him with that right hand, too, in some of these wild exchanges. You know, you can start to see Ballard. You can see exactly what he's trying to do. He's trying to enter with that inside leg kick, step through it, and then throw that big overhand left. Catalan saw it coming, was able to step out the way, and then initiate a nice little exchange. But we're starting to see this Greco-Roman style wrestling from Ballard. He's a three-time Pan American Greco-Roman wrestling champion. So Greco-Roman means they usually take down from the upper body. They don't have a lot of leg attacks. This is one of them.
Oh, he picked him up!
Oh, what a balance! What a balance from Catalan. That was beautiful. He got up. Usually, Ballard finishes from that position.
Oh, and again! There's the takedown from Gustavo Ballard!
It was a beautiful belly-to-belly right there. That was that Greco-Roman style that I'm talking about. All upper body clinch work. Throws.
Nice cross drop and elbow there from half-guard position for Gustavo Ballard. No chance to use the Muay Thai. Still the Wushu styling for Catalan. Catalan also a two-time national Wushu gold medalist. Let's do that off his back. This is Gustavo's world. This is the life built. The life man. Where does Catalan go from here, Dragon?
You can see Matrilla. Beautiful job. He's going back up to his feet. Let go of the half guard. Lean into the body lock to get back up to his feet. But he's caught, man. Front headlock from Ballard. Ooh, Ballard connects with the left hand.
Oh, look down from the Cuban. Some knees now from Catalan. Oh, elbow! Open elbows on the inside. That's a front hook down from Ballard. Round kick from Catalan. Ballard flying the left hook again from the Cuban. And the knee from Catalan almost folds him in half. Amazing scene to the opening round. Overhook the end there from Catalan. On the left arm of the Cuban. A 156-meter tall bundle of power is Gustavo Ballard.
I like how Ballard's entering into some of these clinches. He's throwing the combinations and he's nice and tight. That distance is covered. He's not paying at the end of any of Catalan's punches or kicks. He's closing that distance. He's shutting down one of the primary weapons of Catalan.
That's a kind of wushu kick. Side kick is the wushu specialty. The legs to the body. Jump turning back kick. Looking to plant the heel to the liver of Ballard. Now Ballard left the right hook to left elbow overhand. Now.
serious power behind these right kicks.
Atala Muay Thai World Champion, Gustavo Velarde, Olympic wrestler, Philippines versus Cuba. Art launching some heavy artillery off his hands at the end of the first round. Both men know what each other offers now. Mitch said the first time in Catalan's career, he has an opponent who is shorter than him. 5 centimeters shorter. Velarde has been a favorite in India all week. We'll see why. Style exhibits will attract anyone. He's doing it again, this Velarde. Catalan can work his round kicks here.
He's doing a really good job of keeping this spacing right here. This is his range. This is what he wants. But Velarde's doing a little bit extra to try to close that distance. You can see him skipping in with the flying knees and the flying punches. Nice little leg kick there. Upended Catalan for a moment. But that's how he's closing the distance. He's trying to fly in, get the clinch, get the body lock, and then look for a takedown. But Catalan's doing a good job of keeping this range. He's utilizing the push kicks and the spinning back kicks just to sort of keep Velarde at a distance so he can utilize that little bit of reach advantage that he has for the first time in his career.
There are 3 submission wins on the record of Robert Catalan. You would never guess. All 3 wins by the same submission. You'd never guess it though from a Muay Thai world champion. 3 heel hooks. 2 of them in the very first round. Showing though that Catalan is capable on the ground. He does prefer the stand up. The wushu and the Muay Thai of Robin Catalan. The wrestling of Gustavo Velarde, who told us earlier this week before the 3. Underrated as a striker, but Mitch is also underdeveloped. He's been working on striking.
Was that good? Was that wrong?
In five of his last 5 green fights, split decision to start over Velarde. 7-2 in bouts to go the distance. His last win was by knockout. It took him just 20 seconds. And some power from the right hand to Cuba.
Good job for Robin Catalan getting back up to his feet. You can see Velarde had him in a slightly precarious position, but Robin Catalan was able to get to a knee and get back up to his feet. He separates, see if Catalan chooses to go back to these kicks to score a little bit of points. Because right now this is a pretty close matchup, and out of Velarde's matches, they are all razor close.
Oh, the high kick from Catalan! Smack bang! And here comes Velarde trying to walk through, goes to the left hook. Overhand lift here from the Cuban and another one. Backs up Catalan.
These seem to be the most significant shots of the match. Body kicks from Robin Catalan. I think they're scoring more heavily than the takedowns and the punching of Velarde.
Is Velarde looking the busier of the two?
He's looking slightly more aggressive with his entries and the takedowns, but he's not doing a whole heck of a lot with them. You have to take somebody down and control their hips and actually secure the takedown. But because of Robin Catalan's ability to scramble and create movement, Velarde's having a hard time controlling him.
Only 1 fantasy game of the 1 Super Act. 61% of fans give the nod to Robin Catalan. Only 59% of the people to Gustavo Velarde. Seconds remaining. Oh, the big cover! And good night, Irene! And the big win for Manila, for the Philippines, and an even bigger win for the Catalan. They're going nuts.
Oh my! That was spectacular at the finish. Robin Catalan was touching up the body the entire match and then chooses to go shin to chin and
leaf Gustavo Bolart with a beautiful head kick. Look at that. Even the guard was up, but he was still able to wrap that shin around the back of the head of Gustavo Bolart. Beautiful.
That's
done.
Contender for knockout of the year right there. Look how Gustavo's entire body planks on the canvas. Boom goes the round kick. Gustavo straightened out. Open the fridge. The Cuban out cold.